All right, young lady. I was wondering who my interrupter was going to be this morning. She always does a good job. Now, if you have a Bible, I want you to find in the New Testament the book of Philippians.
让我们一起来翻到腓立比书的第一章。
And we're going to be looking closely at a couple of verses in two different chapters, but chapter one to begin with. So get out your notebook and get your pen and take some notes.
我们接下来的话呢，会看几章圣经。第一个是从腓立比书的第一章开始看，然后呢，我还要看一下第三章。那我们请大家就把你的笔记本都拿出来，你们可以开始做笔记了。
You're saying, does Pastor Hart have a word from the Lord this morning?
因为今天有一些非常郑重的话要给我们讲，神要给我们讲。Well,
yes, he does. And you need to write it down. It's that important. Amen?
如果神对你说什么，你需要写下来的。I
promise you, if you don't write these sermons notes down, you'll forget them before you get home.
我敢保证，你要不写下来的话，那你离开这个教会，你就会忘记了。
The worst ink is better than the best memory.
好记性不如烂笔头。And
if it's from the Lord and not just from Pastor Ron Hart, if it's from the Lord.
因为我们今天听到的真的不是从他牧师来的，是神要对你说的。
That's pretty important, don't you think? Okay, it's right out of God's word. I have pastored so many years and learned so many things about pastoring. Sometimes the pastor's job is to comfort the afflicted.
有时候牧师的工作是要去安慰那些忧伤的人。
People come to church because they want to be made to feel good and feel better and go home rejoicing. Oh, that was a good sermon.
因为有时候弟兄姐妹来到教会，他需要自己能够真的是被医治，离开教会的时候他会喜乐，感谢主。But
sometimes the message is not to comfort the afflicted. Sometimes the message is to afflict the comforted.
但是有时候呢，我们的这个信息不是来安慰这些受伤的人，而是要让这些满得安慰的人来到提醒，来得提醒或者受伤害。You
see the title of this message?
你今天看到我们今天的题目吗？
What God expects from His church.
神对他的教会有什么样的期望呢？
Now I know in my own life, and I know you well enough, that we spend a lot of time telling God what we expect from Him.
因为我知道在我的生命中，或者你们也会经历到这样的一些时候，我们会告诉神，我们从神那里期望得到一些什么。We
expect Him to forgive us.
我们期望他能够赦免我们。
We expect Him to be building a mansion for us in heaven someday.
我希望他在天上为我们建一座大大的庄园。We
expect Him to provide. My God shall supply all of your needs, the Bible says. We expect that, don't we?
我们期待神给我们每一天的供应，然后为我们预备一切。We
expect Him to comfort us and bless us. That's good.
我们期待神能够安慰我们，能够祝福我们。
Why, the list goes on and on. God is a giving, good, blessing God.
Yeah, 我们的这个清单可以一直写下去，因为神是一个供应者，神也是一个祝福我们的神。But
that's not what I want to talk to you about this morning.
但是今天我们讲的不是这样的一个信息。I
want to talk about what God is expecting from you.
我要告诉我们今天要讲的是神对我们有什么样的期望。
As a church, what God expects from His church.
作为一个教会，神期待他的教会做些什么？
And what God expects from you as a part, a Christian, an individual.
作为一个基督徒，神对你有什么样的期待？
You might be shocked to know that God saved you for a purpose.
你应该会知道神拯救你是为了一个目的，是有一个目的的。
He saved you to serve him.
他拯救你是为了来侍奉他。
Well, I see glee just busting out of all of your faces right now.
哇，我现在看见你们脸上都发光了。
We as believers are called many things. We're called saints.
在圣经里边，我们会有很多的名称，我们会被称为圣徒。
We're called stones. Did you know that? Living stones. Jesus is the cornerstone, building up the church of God.
我们也被称为活石，就要建造成为灵宫，就是耶稣基督房角石上所建造的。
We're called sons and daughters, children of God.
我们被称为神的儿女。
We're called servants of God.
我们被称为神的仆人。
The word church in the original language of the New Testament, Greek, is the word ekklesia.
教会这个词在希腊文里边称作 ekklesia.
Ekklesia. In Greek, the word ek means out.
在希腊文里边 ek 就是出来的意思。
And the word ekklesia means we translate that word church, but it means we are the called out. We're called out.
所以希腊文的这个词如果直接的翻译为中文的话，就是我们是一群被呼召出来的人。
Jesus said, even though you're in the world, you're not of the world.
耶稣说，你们虽然在世上，你们不属于这个世界。
Now our citizenship is not in China.
所以我们
it's not.In the United States, our citizenship is in heaven.
所以我们不是中国的居民，也不是美国的居民，我们是天国的居民。
And when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be.
有一天我们都要一起回到天家，因为我们是属那里的子民。
But guess what? We're not in heaven yet.
那可惜我们现在还没有在天堂。
And we are to shine.As lights in this world.
但是我们在这样的一个世界里面，我们要发光。
Our theme this year.
我们今年的主题是。
I hope it'll be our theme every year.
我希望这是我们每一年的主题。
Jesus said, let your good works, your life as Christians. This is what God expects from you. Let your light so shine by your good works that...People will glorify your Father in heaven.
是我们的就是为基督在这个世界上发光，以便人能够把荣耀归于神。
Your good works.
你的好行为。
I have learned this as a pastor. Don't touch the glory. It all belongs to Him.
我作为一个牧师来讲，我学习到了。不要去触摸神的荣耀，因为荣耀是归于神的，是属于神的。
And so would you live your life for him?
所以当你来为神过你的生活的时候
And people say, you're different. What makes you different? Why are you so, such a wonderful person?
当人们称赞你说，哇，你真的是非常不一样，你是这么好的一个人。
You glorify your Father in heaven. Amen?
你要把你荣耀给到我们天父。
He gets the credit. Once in a while, I preach a good sermon. Once in a while.
有一次我讲过这样一篇信息。
And somebody will meet me at the door and say, Oh, Pastor, that was a good sermon this morning.
有人就告诉我说，哎呀，牧师，你这个讲的实在太好了。
Sometimes I say, Yes, I know the devil already told me.
他说我知道，因为魔鬼已经告诉我这样，这么告诉我了。
But if I'm smart, I'll say, Well, thank you, praise the Lord. He gets the credit for it.
有时候呢，我也是微笑，我说，感谢主，荣耀是归给神。
We're going to end with a verse, but I'm going to quote just a piece of it right now. Don't look it up. It's in the Gospel of Luke, and it's in the 14th chapter of Luke, 12th chapter, and we'll look it up and read it at the end of the sermon.
Okay.
But just in that, I want you to know what that verse says as we get started.
待会儿我们会读一段圣经，是在路加福音第十二章。那我们现在先不读，我们在结束的时候会把这个经文放出来。
A part of it says, and to whom...Much is given, much shall be required.
里面讲到是给谁多，就向谁多要。
Has God not blessed you? Has God not blessed our church?
现在神有没有祝福我们，祝福我们的教会？
So God requires, God expects us to respond as His church.
所以神也期待我们作为一个教会来回应他。
Now there's three points to our message this morning.
今天我们给大家分享三个点。
Found right here in Philippians chapter 1 and a few verses in chapter 3 and 4.
这几点都能在腓立比书里边讲到，大多数来到第一章，还有一些在第三章。
What God expects from His church.
教会对，神对他的教会有什么样的期待呢？
He expects us to stand our ground. Stand your ground. We'll cover that in a moment.
他期待他的教会坚守他的阵地。
He expects us to... I can't hardly read that. I got the wrong glasses on, I guess.
Strive for the gospel.
All right. Stand your ground. Got my notes.
神期待我们作为教会坚守我们的阵地
Strive for His glory
而且是为福音而奋斗
And sacrifice for the gospel
就是为他的荣耀为他的福音而牺牲
Let's begin to read here in verse 27
让我们一起来读第27节
In chapter 1 in Philippians I love the book of Philippians
我特别喜欢腓立比书这一卷书。
Paul says in chapter 1, for me to live is Christ, and to die is gain.
在这张书卷里边，保罗说到，我活着就是。
That whether I live or die, I might magnify him in my life.
或生或死，我都要让基督在我里边显大。
In fact, we sang a wonderful, oh, by the way, thank you for all those great songs this morning. And we sang a song that said, Magnify him, King of kings and Lord of lords. Do you remember that song?
顺便提一下我们今天的敬拜的诗歌非常非常的好。你们记得刚才唱的吗？让主尊大，他是。
That Paul knew what was expected of him, whether he was in prison, whether he was in Philippi, whether he was in the church, or whether he was in jail. I just want to glorify, magnify Jesus in my life.
所以我们看到保罗的生命，不管他是监狱里边，不管他是在被逼迫的时候。他的生命就是让基督在他里面显大。
That's what God expects from you.
这就是神对我们的期待。
For you to say it's not I, but it's Christ living in me.
因为不再是我，是在基督在我里面活着。
And I want to magnify this Jesus who's come into my heart and into my life.
让这位来到我生命里边的主耶稣基督在我身上显大。
The songwriter said, "Let others see Jesus in you."
有一首诗歌讲到让。其他的人在你身上看到基督。
We sang a song this morning about crowning him, King of kings and Lord of lords.
我们今天的诗歌也唱到我们要把神百界的荣耀都给他因为要把冠冕和尊荣都给我们的神。
Didn't they crown somebody yesterday over in England?
你们今天知道吗最近我们刚好在给谁加冕了在英国的时候。
You know, the Bible says, someday the kingdoms of this world,shall become the kingdom of our God and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever.
让我们让现在这世界上的这个国度都成为让神在我们里边永永远远作王。
Songwriter said, bring forth the royal diadem, crown him Lord of lords. We've already done that, haven't we?
我们要把冠冕加给基督加给神我们已经这么做了吗
I believe in every heart, God just put it in every heart, a cross and a crown, and we all have to decide.Whether we're going to give him the crown or whether we're going to keep the crown for ourselves and give him the cross.
我想我们每个人面前都有两个选择十字架和冠冕我们是把冠冕给神呢还是冠冕留给自己把十字架给到神
The Bible says someday the kingdoms of this world will become the kingdoms of our God and of his Christ. Someday every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that he is Lord.
因为圣经上告诉我们，有一天万膝都要跪拜，万口都要承认他是主。
Revelation 19 says that when we see him coming on a white horse, when he comes out of heaven the second time, he will have a diadem Many died, many crowns upon his brow.
启示录十九章告诉我们，基督有一天会骑着白马再来。当他再来的时候，他的冠冕上有镶满了宝石。
But until that day,
但是在那天到来之前，
we who have bowed our knees to Jesus,
我们屈膝在基督面前的，
we who are a part of the body of Christ, the church,
我们作为基督身体的一部分，就是我们的教会。
Instead of spending all of our time telling God what we expect Him to do, and we do expect Him to come again, don't we?
除了我们每天就是对神有什么样的期待，当然我们会期待他再来。
We expect Him to lead us as sheep through the valley of the shadow of death and prepare for us a table in the presence of our enemies.
我们期待神从死荫的幽谷里边把我们领出来，也期待着神在我们敌人面前为我们摆设宴席。
We expect someday to dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen?
我们也期待着有一天在神的殿中永永远远跟他同在。
But until that day,
但是在那天之前，来到之前，
with those wonderful anticipations, the best is yet to come.
尽管我们有这么美好的盼望，
What does he expect of you?
神对我们有什么期待？我们来思考。
And what does he expect of this church?
神对我们这个教会有什么样的期待？
Well, I'm glad you asked me.
很高兴你们问到这个问题。
Three things. And three times I'm going to ask you this question with each of these three points.
三件事，就是我们今天讲的三点，我就要问你三个问题。
I'm going to ask you a rather disturbing question.
我现在要问你一个可能让你心里边觉得不舒服的一个问题。
I want you to say this to yourself.
我希望你自己对自己说，
What would my church be if every member was just like me?
我想要你问自己，如果我们教会的每一个弟兄姊妹都像我一样，这个教会会是什么样子？
Got it? That means, did you hear me? Did you hear me? Did you listen?
你听到我想问的吗？
All right. What God expects from his church. Three things in just this passage of scripture. Stand your ground, strive for the gospel, sacrifice for his glory.
从今天我们要读的经文当中，我们知道神对我们的期待至少有这么三件，就是要坚守你的阵地，要为福音而奋斗，而且要为神的荣耀而牺牲。
Verse 27 reads, Only let your conduct be worthy of the gospel of Jesus Christ, so that whether I come and see you or whether I'm absent, I might hear of your affairs, that you stand fast in one spirit, and with one mind you strive together for the faith of the gospel.And not in any way will you be terrified of your adversary, which is to them proof of perdition, but to you it is of salvation that is from God. For to you it has been granted on the behalf of Christ, not only to believe in him, but to suffer for his sake.
我们今天要读的这几句经文这么说，只要你们行事为人与基督的福音相称，叫我或来见你们，或不在你们那里，必听见你们的景况，知道你们同有一个心态，站立得稳，为所信的福音齐心努力，凡事不可怕敌人的惊吓，这是证明他们沉沦，你们得救都是属于神，因为你们蒙恩，不但得以信服基督，并要为他受苦。
It is true that salvation is free. It is a gift of God. That's what the word grace means, doesn't it? It's free. It's a gift.
救恩是免费的，是一个礼物，这确实是真实的。
But even though salvation is free, discipleship will cost you something.
但是虽然救恩是免费的，但是呢，作为基督的门徒，你还是要付上一些代价的。
Remember, Paul wrote this from prison, right?
你们大家记得保罗写这件书的时候，他是在监狱里边。
I know of at least four prisons that Paul spent some time in, maybe five. Paul spent time in at least five different prisons.
Yeah. 我知道从圣经上来，我们会知道保罗可能曾经有至少是五次在监狱里边。
Yeah, the first one was in Philippi, who he's writing this letter to, the little church that got started there. He spent some time. Remember when the earthquake came and the bars went open? That was it. He started that church in Philippi.
在腓立比，他其实是建立了这家教会。在这个地方，他写腓立比书的时候，他也是在监狱里边。
But now he's in prison in Rome. Not the first time, not the last time.
但是他写这卷书的时候是在罗马的监狱里边，这不是他第一次坐监，也不是最后一次。
And he doesn't know whether he's going to be executed or exonerated. He doesn't know.
之后他不知道他会被判刑还是被。
And Paul would say, "That's not important to me."
但是保罗说那些都不重要。
God showed me how to turn this prison into a palace.
神已经教会我怎么样把现在这个监狱变为一个宫殿。
He lived above the circumstances in his life.
保罗的生命完全的在他的环境之上。
And here in this first chapter, he says, I want to go and be with Jesus. Oh, I really am excited about dying. I want to go and be with the Lord.
因为在这篇书他说到他真的是特别想望去跟主同在，就离开这个世界与主同在是何等的美好。
He looked at death as if it was a friend that was going to hasten him home to God. A friend, death. Paul considered death a friend.
保罗把死亡当作是他的朋友。
Just like David said, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'll fear no evil.
就像今天我们读的诗篇第23篇，他走过死荫的幽谷，但是呢，不怕遭害。
Jesus came to take the pain out of parting, the sting out of sin, the dread out of death.There's another one I can't remember.
但是耶稣来到这只世界上，把这个我们对死亡的惧怕 ，I remember even less， 把这个对罪的捆绑都除去了。
And so Paul said, "Life or death, I just want to magnify Jesus. For me to live is Christ."
所以保罗说，或生或死，我都要让基督在我身上显大。
Now when Paul wrote to the church.At Philippi, he must have loved that church a great deal. He started that church, as we said, with the Lord's help, of course.
因为保罗在写给腓立比书这腓立比这个教会这卷书卷的时候，真的是他是很爱这个教会。我们都知道，他实际上自己亲自建立了这家教会。
Better said, the Lord started that church with Paul's help. That'd be a better way to say it.
或者更确切的说，是神建立了这教会，借着保罗的手。
The leaders of this church.Some of them are still here that started this church. Some, like Yi Ping, has gone to be with the Lord. But those that started this church knew that God expects some things from each of us as church members.
那家教会的领袖还有他们教会的成员，他们都知道，他们非常的清楚神对他们的教会的期待是什么。
Again, look at verse 27 in chapter 1.
我们再来读第二十一章的第二十七节。
Let your conduct in my Bible, the word is conduct means your way of life, your manner of living, be worthy of the gospel of Christ.
这里说让你们的行为或行事为人与基督的福音相称。
If somebody were to ask you, what is the gospel? Could you define that?
如果有人问你说福音到底是什么，你可以给福音下一个定义吗？
Now, a lot of people are confused.
有的人可能就会有点迷糊涂，有点迷惑。
In 2 Corinthians chapter 11, the Bible says that Satan has a gospel. He likes to have a counterfeit gospel.
因为在哥林多书里面讲到，就是魔鬼上也有一个福音，他为了来迷惑我们，教我们一些。
In Galatians chapter 1, Paul says, if anybody shares any other gospel than that which you have heard,Let him be accursed. There's only one gospel.
在加拉太书保罗警告那边的教会说，如果有人给你传一个别的福音，你们不要相信，因为只有一个福音。
Some people think that the gospel is just try to be good.
因为有的人是想，就福音就说，让我们尽量行善就好。
Love your grandma and don't kick the cat, and that's the gospel. But the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, listen to this. Paul says, this is the gospel. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, this is the gospel.
在哥林多书那个保罗告诉我们，这就是福音。
Jesus died for our sins according to the gospel.
基督按着福音，按着圣经为我们的罪死，这就是福音。
He was buried and rose again and lives today according to the gospel.
按照圣经，他被杀、被埋。然后又复活，第三天复活，这就是福音。
According to the scripture and according to the gospel, that is the gospel.
按照圣经，这就是福音。
And Paul is saying here, whatever you do, don't get off track. He says, stand your ground. It is a military word, to stand fast.
保罗告诉我们，不管你做什么，不要被吸引偏离正路，我们都要坚守阵地。这里我们讲到的是一个军事上的用语，是要坚守阵地。
Now, the trouble with so many church members today is, I've said it before, they become believers, they get saved, they have Jesus in their heart, and it's a thrilling, wonderful experience. You have joy and peace and a new purpose for life.
但是有时候我们教会有这样的一个问题，很多弟兄姊妹得救了，然后也有了一个新的盼望，新的生命，什么都很好，也有很多的平安喜乐。
They get saved, but then they get over it.
他们得救了，好像就结束。
They lose the wonder.
他们失去了。
And they forget the purpose.
他们忘记了他们。得救的目的是什么?
This word, stand your ground, implies that there's an opposition to our Christian walk that we all face.
这里说要坚守你的阵地，实际上就隐含着一层意思，就是说实际上有一个反对的势力，实际上要来攻击你。
Hosea, a prophet in the Old Testament, made this statement for God. My people are prone, they're given, they lean toward backsliding. We lose ground in our commitment to the Lord. It's natural.
何西阿书这个先知何西阿有对他的子民，神的子民有个提醒，就说我们现在是有一个倾向会失去我们的阵地。
The devil,
魔鬼。
Will always be trying to knock you off your spiritual equilibrium.
魔鬼时时地准备着要把你从你的在圣灵里的一个得到的地位给推翻。
Paul says, stand fast.
所以保罗在这里告诉我们要坚守你的阵地。
Don't try to sing this song. But there is a song you might know.
有一首诗歌。
It's called stand up for Jesus.
是为耶稣基督站立。
You soldiers of the cross.
你是神的军兵。
Lift high his royal diadem.
要为神的荣耀而活。
We must not suffer loss.
We must
not suffer loss.
哦，我们不能接受损失。
Victory into victory we march.
我们要不断的得胜前进。
The devil will try to knock you down.
魔鬼随时都想来攻击你。
I heard about a football coach.
有一次有一个足球的教练。
Football in America is different than soccer. You know that, right?
你们知道美式足球跟
It's a pretty tough game. Guys are always getting hurt in football.
我们通常说的足球不一样。他那个美式足球的。
And somebody asked this coach, "What kind of players are you looking for your team?"
很 tough 的哈，然后呢，他们有人就问这个教练说：“你寻找你的球员有什么样的你看中的是什么
？”Are you looking for players that never get knocked down, never lose their balance, never fall？
你是不是来寻找这样的一些球员，就是从来不会被打倒，从来不会失去他的阵地的
？The coach said, "No, I'm looking for fellows that when they fall, they get right back up."
他说：“不是，他说我要找的是说。”他们会被打倒，但是他马上会站起来。
You know, stand. Get back up.
站起来，尽管被打倒了，还能站起来。
I'm amazed what how little it takes for so many church members to quit and to give up.
我有时候真的是很惊讶，我们好多的这个教会的成员很容易就放弃了，很容易就打倒了，就不再起来。
Aren't you glad Jesus didn't go back to heaven early and say to his father, Father, it's just too tough?
你有没有想过，如果耶稣来到这个世界上，很早的就回到天堂说，哎呀，不行了，这个太难了，我不要再往前走了。
I got 12 guys that said they'd follow me.
我有12个人说是要跟从。
And I don't have much confidence in any of those guys.
你看看这些人，他们是什么样的一个情况。
So get somebody else for the job.
能不能给我选一些其他的人来跟随我？
Where would we be if he had said that?
如果他这么说了，我们今天会在哪里呢？
The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 6, stand and put on the whole armor of God, and in everything stand against the wiles of the devil.
以弗所书告诉我们，我们要站立得稳，我们穿上神的军装，还要站立。
Stand your ground. You know, sometimes it's easier to win the victory in our lives as a believer than it is to maintain that victory.
所以说这里叫我们要能站立，有时候我们是发现你去赢得属灵的征战比你能够坚守这个阵地可能还容易一点。
Let me ask the question.
我再来问大家一个问题。
What would this church be if every member was just like me? Put it personal.
再自己再思考一下，如果教会里的每一个成员都跟我自己一样，就你自己一样，这个教会是什么样子？
Are you willing to stand up for Jesus?
你愿意为耶稣基督来站立，来坚守这个阵地吗？
At school, at work, in your family?
在你的学校，在你的家庭，在你的工作岗位上。
You've heard the expression, if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for everything.
你知道有人说，你如果不为某一件事情站立的话，你就什么都失败。
Stand your ground. Second point.
所以第一点就是为守住坚守阵地。第二点。
Well, wait a minute. I left a lot out. I've got to cover this. Stand your ground. We're still on point number one. Second slide. Good. Thank you. Put that up there. Why?Because of the peril of a self-indulgent life.
所以为什么要坚守你的阵地呢？其实有好几个原因。第一个就是因为自我沉迷的这种宗教意识是很危险的。
Let me read this to you.
让我给大家再读一节圣经。
In chapter 3, verse 17 and 18.
在腓立比书第三章的17、18节。
Brethren, join in following my example.And note those things, those who walk, as you have us for a pattern, Paul says. For many walk of whom I have told you often, and now tell you weeping. Notice the word many, many, that they are the enemies of the cross of Christ. These are people that join the church he's talking about. Many of them. They started out well, but they've...dropped off, many of them, and lost their zeal, commitment, and joy. And he goes on to say, they're enemies of the cross, whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly. They're just sensual. They're just physical pleasures. If it's comfortable, if the pews are comfortable at church, if it's cool when I get to the auditorium in the summertime, if they have good food at the dinner after Sunday school, he says, whose God is their belly? That's just fleshly. And they are enemies of the cross. Instead of embracing the cross and loving the cross and lifting up the cross.
这里他讲到就是第腓立比书第三章十七十八节说，弟兄们，你们要一同效法我，也当留意看那些照着我们榜样行的人，因为有许多人行事是基督十字架的仇敌。我屡次告诉你们，现在有流泪的告诉你们，这里讲到有很多，这里讲到的仇敌山就是在教会内的。他用仇敌这个字眼，因为这些所谓的信徒，他们慢慢的在教会里边变得很舒适，他们很享受教会的生活，他慢慢的就失散了， 成了，反而成了基督的仇敌。这里边讲到屡次告诉他们，然后这样的人还是有很多。同样的一章圣经里面还讲到他们的啊信的，就他们所关注的就是他们的肚腹，就是为了吃饱，为了喝足。
He says, "Stand your ground because of the perils of a self-indulgent religion, and also because we possess a spiritual residence." Look at verse 20.
所以第一点为什么要站住，就是因为你这个一个自我满足的一个啊状态是非常的危险的。那第二点要讲到，就是我们现在是拥有一个属灵的居所。
Stand your ground because, he says, our citizenship is in heaven, from whence we also eagerly wait for the Savior, the Lord Jesus.
因为这里讲到是我们是天上的国民，而且等候救主，就是主耶稣基督从天上降临。
Our residence, this world is not my home, folks.
所以这个教会不是我们的家。
Can you say that?
你能不能这么说？这个世界不是我们的家。
And this world itself is no friend of grace that's going to help me home to heaven. It's my enemy, this world.
而且这个世界是我们的敌人，并不是我们的朋友，并不能帮助我们留在神里面。
John says in the second chapter, 1 John, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world.
因为约翰在约翰二书里面告诉我们，不要爱这个世界和世界上的一切。
Stand your ground because of the peril of a self-indulgent religion. Stand your ground because of we possess a spiritual resident. Go to the next slide.
所以我们刚才讲到了，我们要坚守阵地，因为这个变得很自我陶醉是很危险的一件事情。而且呢，我们要知道我们的居所是在天上。我们下面讲第三点。
He says in verse 20, we are eagerly waiting for the Savior, our Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our lowly bodies that it might be conformed to his glorious body when he comes.
这里圣经上说，我们却是天上的国民，并且等候救主，就是主耶稣基督从天上降临。他要按着他那叫万有归附自己的大能，将我们这卑贱的身体改变形状，和他自己荣耀的身体相似。
Now there's four good reasons to stand the ground. It's worth it. It will be worth it all.
所以我们今天要讲的有四点原因让你要坚守阵地，这些都是非常非常好的重要的原因。
But he also says in that 27th verse of Philippians chapter 1, we are to strive for the gospel. It's an athletic term, striving, wrestling.
对，同样的话呢，在第27节他也讲到我们要为福音而努力，这个词 striving 就是英文的，就可以翻译成是奋斗或者是摔跤的意思，是一个体育上的用语。
And he says we're to do it together. Did you see that? In unison and in unity as a church body, we are to stand our ground and strive for the gospel.
而且保罗在这里告诉我们，我们一起站立，一起为福音努力。是要一起来做的，就像刚才我们读的经文说，你们要同有一个心智，一起站立得稳，来为所信的福音齐心努力。
Now the third reason is to sacrifice for his glory.
最后一个神所期待我们的，就是为他的荣耀而牺牲。
Philippians chapter 1, 28, 29, and 30.
这里边我们会读《腓立比书》的第一章的28、29节。
He says, "And not in any way terrified by your adversary, which is to them proof of perdition, but to you salvation that is from God. For to you has he granted on the behalf of Christ not only to believe in him, but also to suffer for his sake."
这里讲到凡事不怕敌人的惊吓，这是证明他们沉沦，你们得救是出于神，因为你们蒙恩，不但得以信服基督，并要为他受苦。
As we get closer to the second coming of Jesus, folks,
当我们越来越近临近耶稣再来的时候，
I believe it's even going to cost more to fulfill the expectations God has for us and for our church.
我相信我们如果想要像神对我们的期待这样去生活的话，可能付上的代价会更大。
Frankly, living in America, there's little price to pay for your walk with Jesus.
有时候我会觉得在美国生活的基督徒，可能来跟从基督要付的代价真的不是很多。
That's changing in America, if you haven't noticed.
但是呢，美国在变。
When John said, in the last days, perilous times will come. Just before the Lord's return, perilous times will come. We're approaching that, folks, all around the world.
但是呢，基督要来的，再来的时候越来越近了。
China's not the only country that makes it difficult on Christians.
现在中国不再是一个唯一的让基督徒的生活变得困难的一个国家。
There are very few countries left in the world that embrace Christianity and the gospel.
越来越少的国家真的能够非常的拥抱或者是支持基督教的信仰。
Read that little magazine called The Voice of the Martyrs. Subscribe to it, and you'll discover that nations all around the world are persecuting Christians now, and that's growing.
Voice of Margaret?
The Voice.
有一个小的一个是就是殉道者的声音的这样的一个杂志。如果你们有机会可以去看的话，那里面会告诉我们很多在全球各个地区或主国家迫害基督教的事情。
In fact, the more we strive for the gospel, we will learn we will sacrifice for his glory.
事实上，我们越是努力的为他的福音来奋斗的时候，我们就越发现我们需要为此牺牲很多。
The same word in the Bible for witness.Is the word martyr. Same word.
其实在原文里边就是做见证实际上跟殉道者是一个词。
So, stand up.
所以我们要站立得稳。
Stand for his glory, strive for the gospel, sacrifice for his glory.
我们要为他的福音，为他的荣耀而奋斗，而且要为此来做牺牲。
Sacrifice for his glory. I'll ask it the third time.
So,
what does God expect from each of us and from our church?
我再一次问大家这个问题，神对我们的教会，对我们每一位，他的期待是什么？
He expects you to stand your ground.
他期待我们能够坚守我们的阵地。
Strive for the gospel.
为他的福音而奋斗。
Sacrifice for his glory.
为他的荣耀而牺牲。
I wrote in conclusion here, God is expecting and requiring more and more of us than ever before.
我这里作为结束的话语哈，我写了这句话说，上帝对我们现在的期望和要求比以往任何时候都更高。
What we have enjoyed in the past has required very little effort on our part.
我们过去所享受的或承受的这些祝福很少需要我们付出很多的代价。
God expects us as a church. He expects you as a Christian.
神对我们教会，对我们每一个基督徒，他的期望是
Stand your ground.
坚守住你的阵地。
Strive for the gospel.
为福音努力奋斗。
Suffer for his glory.
为他的荣耀而受苦。
Salvation is free.
救恩是免费的。
Following Jesus is going to cost you something.
但是跟从耶稣要付上代价。
Paul says, don't be an enemy of the cross.
保罗告诉我们，警告我们说，不要做十字架的仇敌。
Jesus says, pick up your cross.
耶稣告诉我们说，背起你的十字架来跟从我。
I'm going to close with that verse that we mentioned at the very beginning in Luke chapter 12.
我们今天在结束之前一起来读刚才提到的那一节圣经。
Luke, it's not on the screen. I thought of it last night and just added it to the message.
其实不在我们的这个幻灯上面，但是我
These are the words of Jesus.
这是耶稣的话。
These are the words of Jesus.
这是耶稣基督自己讲的话。
Verse 43, he says in Luke chapter 12.
在路加福音第十二章。
Blessed is that servant whom his master will find so doing when he comes.
他就说这个仆人是得祝福的，如果他的主人回来的时候看发现。
And then at the end of that chapter, not quite, but at verse 48 it says, For everyone to whom much is given, from him much shall be required.
就意思说，因为多给谁，就向谁多取；多托谁，就向谁多要。
Does this message of what God expects from His Christian, from His church, does it trouble you?
我们今天讲的这个信息，就是神对他的教会，对他每一个基督徒所期望的这个信息，会让你觉得很受搅扰吗？
As I said a moment ago, we've been kind of sliding along in our walk with Jesus.
就像我刚才提到的，我们真的慢慢慢慢的，我们就会走在跟随基督的路上，可能会走下坡路。
But the time is coming when a comfortable, casual, careless Christian life is not going to make it.
但是呢，时候要到，就是我们这种非常容易的、非常享受的、非常舒服的这种基督徒的生活可能要结束。
God is saying to Tucson Chinese Christian Church,
神对我们图森的华人教会是这么说的。
Stand your ground.
坚守你的阵地。
Strive for the gospel.
要为福音而奋斗。
Sacrifice for his glory.
要为神的荣耀而牺牲。
Let's pray.
让我们一起来祷告。
Father, when we think of the cross,
哦，天父，我当我们想到这个十字架的时候
，and the price that Jesus paid,
而且耶稣基督为我们付上的代价
，so that we could expect your blessings,
让我们因此而得祝福
，so that we could expect to be forgiven,
让我们可以被赦免
，so that we could have.Expect the presence of Jesus in our life and in our church.
让我们可以期待耶稣基督的同在会跟我们的教会一起。
So we could expect the gift of eternal life.
让我们可以盼望有永生。
So that we could expect a home in heaven someday.
让我们有盼望有一天可以回到天家。
Thank you, Father.
主啊，我们为了这个感谢你，天父。
We know you expect us.
但是我们也知道你对我们也有期待。
To be faithful.
你期待我们信实，对你信实。
To pay the price.
付上代价。
To take the stand.
为我要坚守住阵地。
Even to suffer for Jesus.
即便要为耶稣受苦，也要这样。
Father, we pray that you'd help us to accept this truth from your word.
天父，我们求你来帮助我们，帮助我们接受这样一个真实的信息。
A word to our hearts and a word to our church.
让我们真的是在我们的心里，在我们教会当中都有这样的一个信息。
We pray this in Jesus' name.